Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. Thank you for subscribing, liking, and sharing. Thank you for the beautiful feedbacks on my vlogs and the 20 days of daily loads of benefit. God bless you. Thank you for the birthday wishes. Most of you are here as a result of gifting me a birthday gift. God bless you. Auntie Khadija, God bless you. Thank you for that massive honor done me on my birthday. And it is my prayer that you recover speedily in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, in today's vlog, I'll be sharing with you, you know, how to wait. Yes, Bible says that the labor of the foolish wearieth all of them because they know not how to get to the city. There is a how to wait. Most people waste their waiting period because they know not how to wait. So I will be sharing with you simple steps to turn your waiting moment to the best moment of your life. Let's jump right into it. Number one, simple step you need to do whilst you're waiting is to love upon Jesus. Increase your relationship with him. You know, see to it that if it was like on a scale of 1 to 10, if it was on 8, you want to take it to 9, 10, okay, whilst you're waiting. You want to love upon Jesus. You want to increase your relationship with him, your fellowship with him. You know, by the time you do that, you will not even know that time has gone. Of course, with God, he is never late. God is the author, the writer of time. He is never late. And as far as long as you're born again, you should know that God can never mismanage your destiny. He is an intentional God. He knows the right time to bring that thing that it is that you're waiting for. It could be a baby, it could be promotion, it could be transfer. Whatever it is that you're waiting for, God knows the best time to bring it to you. He knows the right timing to do it. So oftentimes, people, for example, those who are trusting God for babies, the moment they are married, society starts asking them, when is it going to happen? People are asking them, you mean you've not scored a goal and all of those things. Now, I know the pressure can be high, but you want to use that time to love upon Jesus. Let your relationship with him, you know, be on another level. I remember when I was waiting for my baby, when I was waiting to have a baby, one of the places I went to that I was told to do a certain test, you know, the total money was about 23,000 naira. Mm-hmm. So when I calculated it, I didn't have it. I had 12,000 naira. So I used the money to, you know, print flyers and, you know, started distributing the flyers. I was radical, you know, going out for evangelism whilst I was waiting. So you want to find something that you would, you know, do. It could be your prayer time, your prayer hour. If you are praying 1 hour, you know, as you're waiting for something, you want to take it to 2 hours. You want to, you know, increase your word study. You want to increase anything that will just make you make your relationship sweeter and better with Jesus. You want to do that whilst you're waiting. Yeah, you could be waiting for someone. You want to, you know, bring out your phone and your, you know, reading the Bible or listening to a message. Just anything that will boost your relationship with God whilst you're waiting is fantastic. Before you know, you'll see that, it's already 1 hour, it's already 2 hours. Oh, I didn't know, because you were engaging the time. You're not just wasting and wailing, you know, away, wasting away the time whilst you're waiting. You were productively engaging whilst you're waiting. And then you see that at the end of the day, it's not really waiting per se. You are investing in yourself as a result of getting your relationship better with Jesus. Another thing you want to do whilst you're waiting is to be spiritually sensitive. Be spiritually sensitive. Spiritually sensitive to know when God is talking, when God is giving you an instruction, when God is telling you something. You want to be spiritually sensitive. Okay, look at the case of Hannah. Hannah was waiting, you know, for her baby. And then she went to Shiloh to pray. In the course of the prayer, Eli came and like, what is it not too early for you to be drunk? How can somebody be drunk this early morning with wine? If Hannah was not spiritually sensitive, she could have just backlashed the prophet. She could have just given the man of God like bath bows, like, you know. She could have just said, if you are a true man of God, at least you should have known that I am praying. Eh? You should have been, you should have known that, you know, I'm a woman of a sorrowful spirit. But she didn't react. She only responded to Eli to say, it is not as if I have taken, you know, wine.
I am a woman of a sorrowful spirit. I'm trusting God for my baby. That's why I am praying. It's as if my lips are moving and I am not saying anything. It's a burden. And then the man of God had to, you know, say a word. And as soon as she got hold of that word, she said, you know, her countenance was no longer sad. She was sensitive enough not to react, but to respond. And then she got what she was looking for by the time she was coming for the next Shiloh. In fact, the next Shiloh, she didn't even have to come. She had to stay to win the baby and all of that. Uh-huh. You see? So be spiritually sensitive. It was in the course of spiritual sensitivity as well that Abraham entertained angels. They were just passing, not that they came to him. They were just passing. And he ran to them and said, oh no, please, you need to rest. You know, the sun is crushing. You need to sit down, you know, wash your feet. Let me bring you water to drink and something to eat before you continue your journey. And as he did, when they finished, when they were done eating, they made a proclamation, a declaration that according to the time of life, your wife would deliver. And that was it. Yes, hospitality is good. Whilst we're waiting, it's good to be hospitable, but still you need spiritual sensitivity to know who to be hospitable with, the time to be hospitable, and all of that. So we need spiritual sensitivity whilst we are waiting. The next thing you want to do is to keep a joyful atmosphere. Yes, a joyful atmosphere. Bible says that with joy shall you draw waters out of the wells of salvation. Yeah, salvation is a well with too many benefits, too many stuff inside the well, but you cannot, it is deep. Well is deep. So you want to use the bailer. Joy is the bailer. So you want to put in the joy, and then as the joy is in, you begin to drag from the well of salvation. You drag your baby, you drag your promotion, you drag your transfer, whatever it is. Just ensure that you have the bailer, which is joy. Joy is the bailer to draw from the wells of salvation. Salvation has everything beautiful that you can imagine, but it's inaccessible without joy. So keep a joyful atmosphere. Keep a joyful atmosphere. Don't let yourself to be depressed by, you know, happenings. What the Bible says, that those that look at the sun do not see shadows. Higher. Those that look at the sun don't see shadows. So you don't want to be looking at shadows. You want to fix your mind on the sun by being joyful and creating that joyful atmosphere. Yes, you don't have a baby yet. It's over how many years, but you're joyful. The promotion hasn't come yet, but you're joyful. You know? There are things you can just do, you know, to activate. Yes, joy is not dependent on circumstances, but it can be activated. It can be there, but, you know, dormant. So you want to activate it by, you know, music, you know, going out, you know, having some, you know, dance, you know, anything. Just ensure that you are joyful. You are joyful. Why should you be joyful? Because God can never mismanage your destiny. God knows what he is doing. Yes, God can be trusted. He knows what he is doing. So you're joyful and joyful and joyful and giving him glory. Whilst Abraham was waiting, he said he staggered not on the promises of God through unbelief, but he was, you know, fervent in the spirit, giving glory to God. Father, I thank you because I know that you know what you are doing. You know, God knows what he's doing. He can never mismanage your destiny. And a music writer said that you have a track record of keeping your word. God has a track record of keeping his word, and he's not about to stop doing it in your time. So be joyful whilst you're waiting. Now, another thing you want to do whilst you're waiting is to keep fulfilling purpose. Yes, you were not born to this earth just to be waiting on things. No, you were born, you were sent here to fulfill a unique purpose. So if, for example, you're waiting for a baby, you want to start fulfilling, you want to keep living the purpose of which God brought you. He didn't just bring you to have baby and then the baby will grow and then you will die. You came to solve a problem here on the earth. So keep solving. If you've discovered the purpose, keep solving. If you haven't yet, use that time to tell God, you know, to reveal himself to you, you know, so that you fulfill purpose. What did you send me on the earth to do? You want to keep living out the life. You want to keep living a purposeful and intentional life. not to just keep waiting. If you're waiting for a baby, you might want to read up on, you know, stuff on how to, you know, parent with ease. You know, read up on things in line with what it is that you're waiting for. You want to fulfill that purpose for which God created you. So you are not just keeping your life, putting your life on a hold, keeping your life on pause whilst you're waiting. Okay, you're waiting to be transferred to another station. You have stayed in a certain station for a long time. Oh, enjoy that place. Enjoy it. You cannot come and use your tears maybe to come and want to make God to do what he's not yet ready for. So enjoy that moment. Fulfill purpose. Perhaps your assignment in that station is not yet done. So you cannot come and go before your time. So enjoy that moment by fulfilling purpose. By fulfilling purpose, live out your purpose. Go ahead and do what God has called you to do. In the course of it, if the baby comes, if the promotion comes, if the transfer comes, fine. Otherwise, enjoy it by living out purpose, the purpose for which God called you or God sent you to that place, or, you know, why you are where you are at the time. So keep living out purpose whilst you're waiting for the next big thing. Now, you want to be genuinely happy for people who have gotten the testimony that you are waiting for. This is so important, to be happy for people who have gotten the testimony that you are waiting for. That's another step. So you're waiting for a baby and there is a child naming somewhere. You don't just lock up yourself in the house or say, if I go now, I will feel sad. Resist that temptation. Go. Rub the powder like they do in some African countries. Rub the powder, the baby powder. Enjoy. Carry the baby. You know, carry the baby and be happy. If you have something, buy something for the baby. You're happy for the mother. You want to even cook food if you can. Share with the woman who just gave birth. You're genuinely happy for people. You're not just saying, oh, Father Lord, this one has happened. This woman has gotten a testimony. When will it be mine? Oh, Father Lord, this one is married. When will it be mine? No, just be genuinely happy for people. As you do in the course of it, there's a rub off. Yours will come. Yours will come. So by all means, stay joyful. Be genuinely happy for people. Increase your relationship with God. Be spiritually sensitive. And then if it is a baby that you're waiting for, you want to be in agreement with your spouse. Bible says, can two work together except they be agreed? No. They can't work together. They can't make progress. Your spouse, you want to take a step towards, let's say, the actualization of having a baby. You want to be in consonance with your spouse. I want to do this. What do you think? Okay, let's do it. And then it will work. I want to do this. What do you think? Okay, I don't think so in my spirit. Then you wait. You don't just go ahead because you are the woman, for example, and then you want to go to this person. You want to attend this church program. You want to attend. They say this man of God is great, or this woman of God. Then you want to be everywhere. When your husband is saying no, you don't want to do that. You want to be sure that you're having your wife or your husband's blessing, you know, whilst you're waiting, so that you can shorten your waiting period. You can shorten your waiting period as you're in consonant or in agreement with your spouse. I know that somebody is waiting for something right now. I know that someone has waited. And truth is, somebody will still wait for something. Now, if you have experienced, you know, if you have waited and now you have the reality of what it is you're waiting for, please put in the comment section the things that you did whilst you were waiting so that we can all read up and learn as well. Let me end this by saying that I understand how frustrating it can be to be waiting on something or seeing people living the life that you are waiting on God for, or having in abundance the very thing that you are waiting on God for. Damn the pressure. Bible says that they that observe lying vanities forsake their own mercy. Don't look at lying vanities. All the questions, all the negative reports, they are lying vanities. Don't look at it. Look at the sun and you will not see shadow. Look at Abraham. Abraham was 75 years when he discovered purpose, and he lived another 100 years to fulfill that purpose, to live out that purpose. So God is never late. You will definitely carry your testimony in your hands. Bible says the expectations of the righteous shall not be cut short. Yours shall not be cut short in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for watching to the end. God bless you. God bless you immensely. Please subscribe if you haven't already done. Share the link with someone who will be blessed by it. Those who have already subscribed, I appreciate you. Thank you for the feedback. God bless you. See you next time. Bye.